My name is Allen Aragon. I'm from the Navajo Nation. I grew up in Crown Point area, which is on the northwestern by Chaco Canyon in that area. Born in Ganado, Arizona. I was raised on a ranch out in the middle of nowhere. As a kid, I always did artwork, just messing with things, leather work, craft work. My mom and my grandmother were rug weavers, and I kind of grew up seeing them do that. And as a kid, I would go to the rug auctions in Crown Point, where a lot of the vendors from Acoma, the Navajo, the Pueblos would go sell their works on like every month in Crown Point. And Acoma lady, I was always interested in her pottery, looking at her work, and was friends with her. One day at another auction, she brought me a piece of clay and told me I should start working in clay. So I started messing with it and did a little bit of civil work. And over the years, I combined the two with pottery and silver. So that's most of my work, what it's made with. And also an artist, Clarence Lee, who is no longer with us. He was like a mentor that always gave me advice and tell me what to do. And little corners here and there of my artwork, so that helped me a lot. With the Navajo, very, very traditional and very sacred. You know, there's always respect the earth and things will, you know, like designs and stuff will come to you, you know, and it's always respect the spirit world and remember the ancestors and always remember the water, the sky, the land. It's a lot of my pieces has things like that that's kind of put together with my design. So I always respect the Navajo culture and all Native American culture. So my designs are kind of abstract, but they still have those meanings and themes with my work. The techniques on my pottery, it's commercial clay that I use to get the brighter colors, which is like a white clay. And my pieces on the jewelry is rolled out and then they're cut and then they'll dry and I'll sand them. And they're painted with the underglaze, kiln fired, and coated with the clear glaze. And after that, I'll form the silver to the piece. I use paint. It's the underglaze that the colors are. A lot of the colors I'll mix to get the bright colors. And some pieces on my miniature pots, they have, some of them had like 850 hours on one piece. Some piece has 450 hours. So they take quite a bit. On my miniatures, I have only do like maybe one or two a year. And then the rest of my work is jewelry. I've done a couple of paintings, but not too many paintings on canvas. I like them all. The jewelries, I love doing the jewelry. The miniatures are more of my pieces that I take more time doing. And I've done very few, like the paintings. I like doing the paintings. I want to do, eventually do into some large scale, but I've never done a large scale. The biggest painting I've done is like 5 inches by 5 inches. So I do have canvas like 4 feet by 4 feet that I bought, but I haven't done nothing with it yet. So hopefully I can get my mind going and do something like that in the future. I was kind of down during the COVID time and still now, because I don't like to work on my work, but I don't have a clear mind. My mind's not free. I don't want my negative energy to go into a piece when I'm working. So this past summer, I didn't do a whole lot of work. I've done a few commissions and stuff, but my paintbrushes sat there for several months, you know, because I just didn't feel like picking them up and with stuff on my mind, you know, just worried about staying safe and worried about, you know, other people and keeping myself safe, keeping my family safe. I have like a miniature, it's like an abstract sculpture. It's done with it's clay. This is took about 450 hours to complete, and it's design. I don't know, kind of designs what I was telling you about with the stars, skies, the mountains, water, how we do, the circles of life and how the world was formed. And the piece that's on the top here is actually sits on top of the piece. It's an abstract piece. Piece on here is actually the heart beat of the of Mother Earth, which was formed. So, and that's that there. Another one is a bolo tie, which is done with the abstract pieces here that I do, and that's hand painted. Kiln fired, and after it's kiln fired and glazed, and I'll set it and do the silver with it too. And that's some of the jewelry pieces I do. And during the COVID time, I didn't feel like doing. I didn't do a whole lot of work, so I decided to do something different. With what I haven't done is got some pillows made, decorative pillows for, at least I'll have something to do when the when I didn't have time to work. I got these pillows made, and it's really out for like a few months. It's like a limited edition, so I'm trying something like that and see how that works in the future to try, pillows or something done with material or something. And that name of that design out of my painting is called Indigenous Dreams. So it works without making a pillow off of that was it's the right call for the name of the pillow with the design. Yeah, I've been mentoring my nephew since he was 5 years old. He's 19 now, and he's doing this jewelry type of work that I'm doing. So he does Indian market, and he does the herd museum. And I'm teaching him. So he's been doing work for since he was 5. So he's done like the herd museum, got awards at the Santa Fe Indian Market, like best in youth category at the Indian Market, also at the herd. So I mean, he's picking it up. So I'm thankful for that. That's the younger person's able to carry on the art. During the pandemic or something, we're dealing with stress, losing family members or friends to COVID or due to mental illness, and it's hard for a lot of artists who they can't make a living, especially when they're out on the reservation to get out and sell. And it's hard for a lot of artists, trying to make a living during these times. But I'm thankful that I have a few clients that follow me, and they kept me busy on some orders over the summer. But I think everybody's adapting to it and learning more about social media and learning how to do Zoom and virtual markets. So I think that's going to be with us for a little while. But I wish everybody a good year coming up, and hope the virus gets under control. And hang on and keep doing our artwork.